In this video, we are going to see how to read file character by character with fgetc in PHP. So the general syntax is fgetc, then within the bracket you have to pass the file handle. So now what this will do is it will read individual character. The previous one what we have seen is they will read a string of characters, whereas here you read character by character. So to loop over all the characters in the file, you can put the preceding statement in the condition of a while loop. When fgetc returns false, there are no more characters to read. So here, if you see that, see, this is a program. First, you assign the handle fopen data.txt and all. You read it in a, you open it in a read mode and you assign the handle to this data.txt. Now, within the while loop, you read, you start reading. So when it becomes false, when there are no more characters, automatically the while loop fails and it comes out. So fchar equal to fgetc of dollar handle. So fgetc, it read one by one character and it will be assigned to this. And in the, within the loop, we are printing. And then when it is over, it comes out automatically. So I'll show this program. See here, it is open. And then, yes, it will be echoed in our screen. Now, this is what the program. See, welcome students to my PHP class. What is the difference between the previous one and this one? In this, what happened? It will read all the data from the text file and everything will be printed in a single line. Okay, whereas in the original data file, welcome students, still welcome students is in one line, to is in another line, my is in another line, PHP is another line, and class is another line. But it is printing everything in the same line. This is because in text file, there will be slash n to indicate that and it automatically it will be entered when the user enter the entry key. So automatically a new line will be created in the text file, but which is not recognized by the browser. Browser recognize only br symbol for line, new line. So now what you have to do is you have to create a, you have to replace the, whenever it reads a slash in notepad in a text file, then it has to be replaced with br of HTML. So that coding you have to write. So we'll see how to do that. See here, you have to replace it. So you are verifying whether the character is equal to slash n. In that case, you replace it with br. So if you add this line in our program, then now it whatever is in the text file, you will be seeing that as such, as it is. Now, so it will read this line, character gets see, it will read one by one character. So when it come across a slash n, we have to replace it with, so we are checking whether it is equal to slash n in the statement in if class. So if so, then we replace it with br, which is recognized by a browser. Browser recognize only this. Okay, now after the replacement it will print. Now so when there is a new line, this will be echoed so that then it will next line, the cursor will go to the next line and start printing. Now we'll see how this gets executed. The same program, see here. So after welcome student, there is a new line is created in the notepad. So it is as such how we are having in our text file. I just show you the content of the text file. So it's similar to that.